my family is from Somalia, and I was raised in America. I remember growing up in a pretty moderate Sunni Muslim household, and I left the religion at a really young age, at around 15. When I first started expressing my opinions on Islam, the immediate action was, you need to read more Quran. And it was a slow buildup. It started first with, let's just read this, you know, passage together, or let's go pray together. And towards the end, it was, you are completely locked off from everybody else. كتاب الله دستوري وخير الخلق أسوتنا بسنته جلا نوري لهدي الحق أرشدنا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Heartbreaking to see people here in the West leaving the religion of Islam. Imams tell me, subhanAllah, I was talking to an imam. You know what he was telling me? The amount of people who have come to his door, people who actually have doubt in the religion of Islam. They have doubt. Some of them actually left the religion of Islam based on maybe university studies or whatever else that it may be. People leaving Islam as if it's no problem. And bigger than all of them, that individual Jamal that we just seen right now. He himself comes from a Muslim household where they actually learn the religion of Islam. Right? And they actually practice the religion of Islam. And then what happens now is, he finds doubt in the religion. And he comes and he talks to his family, and his family turned the blind eye to him, saying what? Go read more of the Quran. Or you probably have a jinn inside of you. Is that the real answer? Shouldn't his family be telling him, وَلَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ? Just like how the Prophet, when he came to his people, he told his people, أَنِعْبُدُ اللَّهِ وَاجْتَنِبُ الطَّاغُوتِ. Worship Allah, right? And stay away from the false deities. They should have just told him what real Islam means. Instead of turning the blind eye and just tell him, go read the Quran. He doesn't even know what the Quran means. Because the Quran was revealed for what? لِيَدَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِ. So you can reflect over the verses of the Quran. So subhanAllah, it's definitely a problem. Now, we're going to divide this video into three major components, inshallah. For anyone that's having doubts, whether atheists are watching this video, Christians are watching this video, Buddhist, agnostic, or whatever it may be, we'll divide the video into three. And anyone who's having doubt, the first one is, I'm going to try to convince you in a short amount of time that Islam is the truth. Number two is, what is the real Islam? What is Islam in and of itself? What are some of the pillars? What are some of the conditions? Third one is, what are some solutions to people who are afflicted by this, right? What are some solutions for people when they come up to you and they speak to you? How are you supposed to react to what they tell you? Now, number one, convincing that Islam is the truth. Brothers and sisters, it is in our natural inclinations that we gravitate towards one God. How? If I ask you the question right now, how many principals in your school? You only say one. There's only one president that runs the whole country. Just like that, subhanAllah, you yourself, you don't even gravitate towards that one God. You're okay listening to one principal or one president. But at the same time, what? You yourself, you don't even bow down or worship that same God. It's in you. You can lie as much as you can, but you're always going to call upon that same one God to help you. And subhanAllah, the question now here is, what about some of the miracles that this religion of Islam came with? If you're still having that doubt upon you know, the religion of Islam, some miracles that the Prophet Muhammad came with. The biggest miracle he came with was that of the Quran. He came to a people, and they had high level of Arabic language. Close to them is ALIF LAM MEEM. ALIF LAM MEEM. These are letters. They don't even know what these letters mean. So some of them get confused, subhanAllah. ALIF LAM MEEM. And Allah even challenges them and he tells them, okay, وَلَوْ اِجْتَمَعَ الْإِنسُ وَالْجِنُّ. If you were to gather all of insan and all of the devils, right? أَنْ يَخْلُقُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ. To Qur'an. لَا يَخْلُقُونَ بِمِثْلِ. They won't be able to like this Qur'an. Something similar to this Qur'an. Even if they helped one another. The Qur'an in and of itself, there's a miracle to it. That what? That it is preserved till today. Not one letter has been added into the Qur'an. Why? Even if you added one letter, and you take all of the Qur'ans and you throw it into the sea, few seconds, well, in and of itself. Why? Because people have memorized the Qur'an. Tell me which other book that people have actually memorized till today.
any book, whether the Bible or any other book in and of itself. SubhanAllah. That's one of the miracles of the Quran that many of us have to know. Brothers and sisters, that one God, He came with, He revealed the Quran to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Muhammad's that vehicle that what? That teaches you how to worship that one God in and of itself. Now look at this. SubhanAllah. What is the real Islam now? Brothers and sisters, Islam sits on five pillars. From them is one of them. The major pillar in Islam is La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. What does La ilaha illallah mean? In English, we translate it as there is no God, no deity worthy of worship except Allah. La ilaha is the first part. It is negation. You're negating anything that's worshipped. Anything, whether it's your money, whether it's your boss, whether anything that you unconditionally obey, or anything that you gravitate towards like that, you're going to negate all that stuff. And then you're only going to affirm that one God in and of itself. Just like how that was already in your heart anyways, just to affirm that. Illallah. And that's what it is. And Jamal, if he was taught La ilaha illallah, I can guarantee you that his heart would have gravitated towards Islam. But is it okay just to tell the person, oh, you have jinn inside of you, just go memorize the Quran, go do this, that. He doesn't even know what the Quran means. The Quran is there so you can reflect upon its verses. That was the reason why the Quran is being revealed. Now look at this, illallah. So I gave you, in and of itself, that is what La ilaha illallah means. That you believe in the lordship of Allah. That you believe that only Allah creates and no one else creates. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who runs the affair of the creation. Number two is that you single out yourself, single out your actions only for Allah. And that is uluhiyah. The third one is asma'. You single out the names and attributes of Allah. If you do all of those, then you have understood the crux of what La ilaha illallah means. That's exactly what it means. And then Muhammad is just a teacher. He taught you that, how to worship Allah alone and do not associate no partner. So if you follow Muhammad, then Allah will be happy with you. And that's exactly how it is. Many of us, if for example, a teacher, Muhammad is that teacher that's trying to allow you to understand that which is inside the Quran, which is the book. A teacher at school allows you to understand the textbook. Right? Can you just read the textbook on your own? Many a times, you're going to fail the class. So therefore, you need a teacher to explain it so you can actually pass the class. That's just the way life is. Muhammad is just that teacher who came to explain, or he came to explain the Quran to each and every one of us. And his ways are revelation in and of itself. SubhanAllah. So that is Islam. And now, anyone, whenever someone comes to you and tells you, I have doubt upon Islam, ask them the question, do you know what La ilaha illallah means? Do you know what Muhammad Rasulullah means? Tell them that. Try to teach them what Tawheed is. From them are books like Kitab al-Tawheed that each and every one of you can learn. From them are books like Usul al-Thalatha, three fundamental principles of Islam. From them are things that actually, the Nawaqid of Islam, things that actually nullify your Islam. These are the things that Prophet Muhammad told the Arabs during his time. And wallahi, after 13 years of having Tawheed in their heart, you know, what happened to them? Wallahi, they changed. So brothers and sisters, one of the angles that shaitan wants to come in, as the devil wants to come in, is he wants to throw doubt into your heart. And that's exactly what it is. So brothers and sisters, we leave it at that. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow each and every one of us to understand at-tawheed. هذا والله أعلم. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.